Hey Wiki Watchers, my name is Dabbles in the Pud and welcome to my cooking show. Today I'm making my lunch for tomorrow and I'm going to show you exactly what I'm going to be making. If you want to make it yourself, you can, it's not that hard. So basically, the stuff that you are going to need is chicken, which I already have prepared, which my mum made a stew, which was actually quite nice. So I've got leftover chicken. You're going to need a sharp knife, a chopping board, and some lettuce. This is some lettuce that I cut up just earlier. So you're going to want it to get, you're going to have to cut it into four pieces. So cutting it down the middle is a good thing, and always make sure that your hand is well away from the blade at all times, because if it isn't, you're going to end up cutting yourself really badly and you could end up going to hospital, which is something that you don't want or anything. And we're also going to be doing a fry up, which I'm going to show you exactly how to do that. Just turn. So now that you have your cabbage done, you can move on to your fryer. And we're doing this with noodles. So with the fryer, you can add anything you want. I have a bit of chicken there which we had. It's only a little bit. I'm gonna cut it up in a few bits. So I'm gonna cut it up in here because it's nice and quick. Same thing again, when you're cutting up chicken to get it into like nice decent bits, use this knife and keep your hand well away from the blades at all times. Don't wave it around like an idiot, because like I said, with the bigger knife, you're going to end up cutting yourself and might end up going to the hospital, which is something that you really don't want to happen. So that's enough for the chicken. So always make sure to wash the knife afterwards. If you don't wash it, chicken is kind of toxic. Well, not toxic. If you don't cook it, it's got salmonella in it, and you don't want to catch that. So make sure that you always clean your knife afterwards. So what we're gonna do is turn the heat on and add the cabbage that you have just cut. I would suggest pushing it with your hand instead of using the knife, because when you're using the knife, it kind of goes everywhere, literally all over the place, and you don't want to do that. You're also going to want to add a few bits of garlic. You can use you can use this, which is a garlic crusher, or if you have a plate like this, you can just scrape the garlic onto that, which is what I'm going to be using for the for the garlic. So I usually put about two, because that's the amount of garlic I like to put. I've never actually used this yet, but it was a gift. You can use the fork for this. Actually, I would suggest using a larger knife. And like I, same thing again, always keep your hands away. From the blade at all costs. So essentially, wash my hands, and now you're going to want to take a wooden spoon and just stir your lettuce around in a circle. You can add, if you want to add a bit of chicken stock, you can. You can add vegetable stock. You can, and if you want to make your own stock, it's quite simple. I might, if you want me to do a video on that, how to make your own stock, I will. I'm just gonna add a little bit of this to give it a bit of a flavour. I believe there's still a little bit more garlic on this. Just like give that a little stir. If you don't want to use that, you can just give it a little shake, which I sometimes do. But don't do it all the time, because it kind of ruins everything. So now, while this is cooking, we are just going to cut up a few bits of chorizo. So if we go back to the chopping board. So I'm going to use two bits, and then what we're going to do is just going to turn down the heat. Thing is, these chorizos, they are quite big, so not to worry. I'm going to move this back a bit so you can see what I'm going to do. Right, you're going to want to layer the two chorizos on top, and same thing again, keep your hand away from the blade. And now we are gonna add the chorizo to the dish. And you're also gonna, if you want, you can add a few olives, which will give it quite a nice flavor. Add a bit of the juice. There we go. Give it just a little stir, And the thing that I like to put in the most is kimchi, which is a Korean, pot with cabbage, which they've made it spicy. So we're just gonna add a little bit of this, not too much, because we don't want it too spicy. If you want to add, if you don't have any of this, you can add your own spices. That should be enough. And also, if you don't want just the lettuce or cabbage, you can also add carrots. You can add any type of vegetable that you want, that you can give it a nice taste to it. Right. Now, we're just gonna turn this off for now. Place it over to the side for a quick second, and now we're gonna do the noodles. So just got the noodles there ready, and just for this, you're gonna want to add some hot boiling water. Make sure you do it in the kettle. Don't just put cold water, because it will take longer for the noodles to cook. So make sure that you use hot water that is quick. And don't bother about doing the stock, because there's no point in actually doing it. While that's boiling, I'm just gonna quickly clean this to get rid of the garlic. And with the stuff that you don't need, you can put it back into your fridge. We're just waiting on the hot water to boil. Then we can do the noodles. As soon as the noodles are done, we're gonna put it into the wok straight away. First off, you're gonna want to put it in. You're gonna want to put the noodles into one of these, into a sieve. Then what you're gonna have to do is take the wok over there, pour the noodles into the wok, which I'm gonna show you. And once this is all finished, this is gonna taste really, really nice. So in a few seconds, the hot boiling water is going to be finished, and we're just going to add it. I'm going to turn that off because it's quite noisy and it's giving me a headache. I'm just going to turn this off, or turn it off. Oh my god. We're just going to let it boil the water. So the hot water is done. So you're going to want to turn on the heat and then just pour all of the water into the pot. There's a little bit left, just leave it, because you won't need all of it. Like, I know I said you need all of the water, but you don't need it all. And then you're going to want to separate the noodles. A bit. And now you're just going to want to wait for it to boil. As soon as you know it's ready, it's going to go all white on the top. So that's how you're going to know that it is all ready. So, while that is cooking, we are just gonna wait for a little bit. Because it doesn't take that long to boil, it takes like a few minutes, and I'm gonna be back. Right, I believe now the noodles are ready because you can see on just on the top that it is starting to boil. Just bear with me. Right, so you can see that it's starting to foam up, so if we just give it a little test, so just make sure you take one out, not loads. So you can put it into your hand just because it is quite hot. Yeah, that's about ready. So you're going to want to turn off the heat. And like I said, now you're going to need to use this. This is where it comes important. Since now the noodles are ready, you are going to want to pour the hot water out and put the noodles into here. And now you're going to want to bring your wok over, hold it from the edge, and just pour all of the noodles into your wok. And then afterwards, what you are going to do is turn back on the heat and just turn your noodles around. I'm going to add a little bit of soy sauce to it to give it a nice flavour. Make sure you give it all, make sure you put it all the way around. If you're that kind of person who likes to put a little bit of salt and pepper, you can as well to give that, I'm not sure if this is, yeah it is, this is the pepper. So with my pepper it doesn't really work, so I have to take the lid off and just, which is annoying. Now you can add just a little bit of salt, not too much salt, because you don't want to make it too salty and disgusting. You can also add some sesame oil, which is going to be quite nice with it. Don't add too much because this stuff is actually expensive. That would help if the lid was off. Don't try this at home. Don't try opening it with your knife because you don't want to cut yourself. I would suggest using it with a blunt. Try opening it up with a blunt knife, like a butter knife you can open it with. You can open it up with a fork. And also don't try jabbing it with your finger. Now take your spoon and then just stir your lovely meal around. You can do this again. As soon as this is done, this is going to taste absolutely brilliant. You can have it for lunch, you can have it for dinner. Well, you can't have it for breakfast because it's not. You could if you wanted, if you like to have noodles for breakfast, you could. It would be quite nice for breakfast, but me personally, I wouldn't suggest it because it's kind of not good. So if you want to add a little bit more stock, just a tad bit, about that much, then just give it a little stir around. And now that's done. So that is your lovely meal done. You can eat it straight away, or if you want to save it for the next day, you can. All you have to do is put it into a place where it's really cold, and then as soon as you get to work or school, you can just slap it in the microwave and heat it up. And I hope you guys have enjoyed my cooking show on how to show you how to make the best noodles with chicken. So if you guys have liked this video, make sure you guys go punch that like button in the eye, and make sure you guys go press that subscribe button, and also press that bell icon, which will get you notified whenever I upload a new video. And also stay awesome, boy puds, and stay cool, girl puds.